Bom, eu tinha prometido hoje uma surpresa, que era fazer uma entrevista a estes dois senhores que eu tenho aqui ao meu lado. À minha esquerda está o Luca de Mel, você já conhece, é o CEO da SEAT e é uma pessoa extraordinariamente simpática. Como sabe, não há pergunta que a gente não faça que o Luca não responda. E ao meu lado esquerdo tenho Herbert Diess, Dr. Herbert Diess, que é só o CEO do grupo Volkswagen. Ora bem, eu vou começar por Dr. Diess. Mr. Diess, are we done with combustion engines?
No, we're not done with combustion engines, but electric drivetrains will play a more important role in the future. And as we are changing towards a CO2-free mobility, the electric engine will become dominant. But over the years, now I would say gradually we will ramp up from probably 4-5% market share in 2020 to probably 15-20% market share in 2025, and up to 14% market share by 2030.
E agora vamos ao Luca. Luca, you've been granted the possibility of developing a new platform in SEAT. Does this mean that these people at the Volkswagen board trust even more SEAT?
No, I think so. They always trusted us, and I think that here's the issue: is a new way of making the let's say group brands work that Mr. Diess has organized in the last couple of years. So everybody's taking a task. We take with a lot of, let's say, pride that task of cooperating with the engineers in Germany to be able to develop something starting from one of the technology we already have. But the idea is to bring a car, you know, electric, pure electric battery car at a price that is accessible.
Under 20,000 euros.
Yeah, under 20, that's the challenge, and we try to see if we are able to do that. And I think it fits completely also the tradition of and the history of SEAT to bring, you know, democratized mobility as we did with the Seicento, you know, many years ago, but now we do it in the new era of automotive. So we are very proud of this thing, and we will work very, very hard to make sure that we can get to the target.
We can deliver. Dr. Diess, this is the first time you come to the annual meeting of SEAT. Does this mean that you trust, or are you showing you trust the company or the brand?
I trust the company, I trust the team. It's a very strong and motivated team, and they have had an excellent track record over the past years. But I'm mostly here
congratulate. In a charming offensive?
No, to really congratulate. I think the team did a brilliant job last year. They delivered record results, record sales, fastest growing brand in Europe, establishing a new sub-brand, I might call it Cupra, which was a huge success so far. It's growing for the first
time. It's interesting because you said at the press conference that you didn't believe in the concept of Cupra very much.
No,
are you satisfied now?
I was skeptical, no, because establishing a new brand is always something complicated, it's costly. Working. It's working, definitely.
Are you surprised?
I'm positively surprised.
Okay, you mentioned before in other interviews that return on investment is your main key indicator now. But Volkswagen Group has been paying huge fines for what happened with the diesel scandal, up to 28 billion euros. Doesn't this affect your investment effort?
So far we can finance the programs we want to finance, so we're investing a lot in new technologies. The group is very robust, the cash flows have been very good over the past years, so we can sustain that situation, yes.
Luca, what do you expect from the Formentor, because this is a new vehicle, new model you showed here today?
But I think that we that's probably the first car we engineer and design with Cupra in mind, right? So, and you can see that it's a very expressive product, very unique with a packaging and the body style, which not many cars like that in the market.
It's a beautiful car.
It's a beautiful car, and it's also new. It's something, you know, new. It's not just a typical thing. And so what I'm expecting is, of course, it will be a success, but also what I'm expecting is that it will kind of position more clearly Cupra, okay, as a brand that is kind of new and different, and I think that car will make it, because it will go into volume for sure. I mean, if I look at the reaction in the web, on the social medias, and or on the Geneva Motor Show, I mean, it's clear that this thing has a lot of potential. The people in SEAT, they think that's the best thing we have ever done. That's what I think. Hopefully the market will say the same.
Mr. Diss, I have friends and also executives who ask me, should I buy a diesel car? If I ask this to the CEO of Volkswagen Group, what do you say?
I recommend diesel cars to many of my friends because, you know, if you look at the, it depends what you do, no? But if you have a bigger car, if you are into towing, if you travel long distances, if you travel, it makes a lot of sense. Even environmentally, it makes still sense because in many countries, you know, the electric energy is produced out of coal, at least partially. So you have a lot of CO2 in the electric energy, which doesn't make sense for electric cars. So the electric cars really has to make its success with the primary energy production converting into renewables, no, into solar and wind energy. This happens. Spain is quite advanced. You have today probably you have very little CO2, no, because you have an airy day and wind in the air. And in many countries in Europe it already makes sense, but there are countries in Europe where you still have a lot of coal in the primary energy where it doesn't make sense. But even so, let's say a diesel car for the bigger cars, for the long distances, for the 30, 40,000 kilometers a year, or 25, 30, it still makes sense. The cars become really, really clean now with the next generation or the current generation.
Let me turn to Portugal. Are you happy with the performance of Auto Europa?
Of Auto Europa. Auto Europa doesn't exist anymore. It's a fully owned Volkswagen subsidiary, and I'm very happy with the performance. The car is doing exceptionally well on the markets. The T-Roc, we're just launching a new, very emotional R version of the T-Roc, which I'm sure will be as stunning a success as the Formentor to come. So I think the team is doing a great job. They're making full use of the capacity we have established.
Are you planning
very flexible? I think not on the short term, but we are working on bottlenecks. The plant is running under full steam, under full capacity.
Thank you, Mr. Diss. Thank you.